right? Because this is readable to us, right? This is not. So we're going to turn the text into a Python object. We can like access the different parts of it. Okay. So now, okay, this looks a little better. There's a lot of stuff, so I'm not going to scroll up. But basically now, data is an object, like type data tells you the type of it. It's a dict, which is a dictionary. And dictionaries look basically exactly the same as JSON. So you use the braces, then you have keys, and then the keys give you values. So now, data, if we want to check out what's in the meta part of JSON, check that out. So now we have another dictionary. Dictionaries are denoted by the curly brace followed by keys. So the status is a key, and 200 is a value. And then there's another key, message. The value is OK. Don't worry about the U's. It's all just the string here.
So how did you get data?
So data, I remember I did data equals json.loads r.text. And that parsed, what it did is it parsed all the text and turned it into a Python dictionary, which has many dictionaries and different things inside it. So remember, I can access the meta part of the response. And if I want to get the status, I can do status.
Oh.
Gives me 200, right? So status equals 200.
Sure.
Right? And then that's the same thing. So that's how you access dictionaries in Python. It's like the dictionary, which is data, then it's the key meta, which gives you a value, which is another dictionary, and then we do another key status. So you just gotta make sure, like, you know what like keys you're passing in, so you don't get a key error. Like if we do stat or something, gave us a key error, it's not there. If you want to like check if something isn't there, you could do status in data meta status. So that statement just returns this expression. All I was doing was status in data meta, which means this status in the dictionary returned by data meta. That's the basics of Python dictionary. Okay, so that's the meta part. What's in the response? The response is everything. What it actually is, it's a list. So if we look back at our browser, you see this is just a straight bracket. Straight brackets in Python are lists. So like, that's how you make a list. You can do 1, 2, 3, 4. Just put back a list of items. It's basically, in other words, it's an array, but in Python they're called lists. You could do like, basic stuff, right? This gives us back a list of dictionaries. If I collapse all these, you can see it's just a whole bunch of things. Yeah. So if we do len data response, there are 20 different pieces of data. Let's reassign this. We'll do post equals data.
I'm going to show you data, just
response. Post, so now post is a list. You can iterate over it. Right? So you can do for post and post. This is how you use a for loop in Python. We will type. We'll just mix it out for now.
Do you need to explain it?
Check out the post URL. So post.
Okay.
Post. And it printed all the URLs in the post. So we can access different parts of it. So what we really care about is the link. link URL. So I'll show you this app I made. If you want, you can go to, this is what I made for the HackNY Hackathon this spring. So if you go this URL, github.com/data-67, I made this app that basically just pulls in random stuff from Tumblr. Anything that's like highly rated on Tumblr, it will pull in. And I'll just show you where this.
Parts like variables, like the tag itself that you want to look up,
the API key, like you don't want to hard code this into your code because it's just going to show up all over the place, and if you change it somewhere, like it might, your API key might change. If you type it wrong, like it'll be bad, right? So you'll get some kind of error. So what I do is I have a settings file, and in my settings file, I have number key. I just paste it in. In Python, like you can import, right? So any file in your project, you can do the file name, then the object in the file. So for example, settings is the name of the file, settings.py, and then Tumblr key is the text, the string, and then I just assign it to Tumblr key here. So then what I'm doing is this function Tumblr tag query string, it takes in my query, like whatever I want to look up on Tumblr, so in this case, if, and then it takes the query in. You have to do one more thing, which is normalize it. So like if it has spaces, you have to be aware of spaces because that will break things. So if we do gif funny, but we had a space here, this will, well, Chrome is smart enough to not include a space, but if we did it with a space in it, it would not complete successfully. So the space here is denoted by the percent 20, so it just replaces it. So you have to normalize your query, and I wrote a function for that. So this is all it is. So all it does is it checks for spaces, or you can also use plus. Plus is another replacement for spaces. So string is just like hello world. String, if we do s.replace, like s, the space on its own is actually a character, it's not just a space. We replace it with a plus, we now get hello plus one, right? So we have to replace any spaces with pluses or a percent 20. And then the pound sign, like you might be using that also, that has to be replaced, that has to get taken out.
Deleted it.
Yeah, it would be percent 23, but in this case, I deleted that.
Mm-hmm.
I don't remember why, but there was a reason for it.
Mm-hmm.
Because percents normally are not used in URLs for like this purpose of requesting data. Right, so I normalize the query, replace any spaces. This is my endpoint, which is just string. It should be in API Tumblr. Then I have the tag variable here, and in Python, if you want to insert a value into a string, you can do this percent followed by the variable, or I mean, we could really just do we can do this plus equals. We'll add it to a string. But this is a if you're adding a lot of content to a string, it's better to use the percent. Before, this is another parameter, like if you want to get post before a certain date, I pass that in, but it's optional. And then what I do is I add to the API call with my key, so I'm just adding the API call string with my key from Tumblr, and then it returns this URL right here with like my actual API call. So it just returns a string. So
so all the variables after the question mark, you're coding.
Yeah, exactly. All the variables after the question mark are get variables. And every single one is delimited by a ampersand, as you can see here. So when we do before, we do ampersand before equals the value. The next one is ampersand API key equals the value, right? So if I ask for the string back with this query, like LOL, this is what I get. Right. So this makes it easy to just not have to type out the URL every time. And actually, like there are better schemes of doing this than what I'm doing, but I want to just make it quick. So yeah, I mean, we turn it into a string. We use request to get the content. That's what this does right here. And then we get the posts exactly as I showed you in the command line, your data response, you get the posts. And then for every single item, we save it. There's a save function I wrote in here. So save post, it takes in this whole dictionary right here, like this is one. It will just take in one of these. And it would save this to the database. And I'm using Django, which is a framework which makes it easy to do this. But I don't have to talk about it. There's a lot more material here. But basically, the way it works is I have a bunch of fields which are on a table in a database, and I have this class for photo. All I have to do is create the photo, so I do photo.objects there, create, and then assign all the parameters to it, and save it. And the end result is this really simple app, which is this.